Have you ever taken an antidepressant for depression and had an inadequate response? You're not alone. More than half the people who take antidepressants don't get relief. We call this treatment resistance. Some recent research has shown that a B vitamin added to your antidepressant may make the difference for you. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos. Recent studies found that adding the B vitamin L-methylfolate, or folate for short, to your antidepressant can be an effective add-on treatment for depression. It seems to work even better in people with a higher body weight and certain inflammatory markers. Folate is one of 8 B vitamins and comes in 3 forms. Folate is what you get from dietary sources like spinach. It has to be processed before it's able to cross the blood-brain barrier and get into your brain and do its work. That processed form is L-methylfolate, and it is able to cross the inner sanctum and get into your brain. Then the third form is the synthetic supplement folic acid. This is what you typically buy in the pharmacy section of your store. Researchers have found that the dose that was effective was about 15 milligrams. The people who took this dose saw significant improvement in their depression. And then there is this interesting connection between body weight and inflammatory markers. People with a BMI of 30 or more seem to benefit more from the addition of L-methylfolate, and those with a BMI of less than 30 didn't see as much benefit. There is a connection between inflammation and the body and brain and increased depression. The connection is that inflammation causes oxidative stress, which blocks the production of the depression neurotransmitters serotonin, norepinephrine, and dopamine. Think of oxidative stress as your body's rusting process. Processed foods, poor air quality, exposure to chemicals, and other things like this cause the cells to produce free radicals that damage the cells. It's this process that people refer to when they say that a supplement or a food is an antioxidant. Antioxidants clean up the free radical mess. But I digress. Let me rein it back in. Obesity, which is currently defined by the World Health Organization as having a BMI of greater than 30, causes increased inflammation, and increased inflammation causes oxidative stress. And then this oxidative stress, or rust, reduces serotonin, norepinephrine, and dopamine. The low levels of these chemicals contribute to the depressed state. So that's the cause and effect here. L-methylfolate comes to the rescue because it helps produce more serotonin, norepinephrine, and dopamine. Antidepressants work to increase these chemicals, and L-methylfolate gives it a boost. Folate also has an important role in DNA production and repair, so it works at the level of cleaning up the cell damage from oxidative stress. And if you're wondering, how would you know what your level of inflammation is? Inflammatory markers can be detected by blood tests. C-reactive protein is one such marker, and it's not usually part of standard blood work, and is something that your doctor would get if they suspected an inflammatory process for you. In the United States, L-methylfolate is considered a medical food and is available as a prescription. I started prescribing L-methylfolate to certain patients about 15 years ago when there was less research supporting its use. But as time has passed, more research has shown its benefits, and I've noticed that more of my patients have had it covered by their insurance. What I didn't know back then when I first started using it was that it worked better in people who were overweight and had higher levels of inflammation. And given the connection between inflammation and depression, this sheds light on some of the possible causes of treatment-resistant depression. It may not be that L-methylfolate is so magical as much as it is that if you have a lot of inflammation for whatever reason, obesity being one of them, you may be less responsive to antidepressants because of the inflammation reducing your neurotransmitter levels. It's like the antidepressants are working to bring up the levels, but the inflammation is working against them to deplete the levels. What does this mean practically? I could see coming out of this research more research on the effectiveness of reducing inflammation as a way to treat depression. And we don't have anything solid yet, but that may be the direction that things are going in. One caveat to treating L-methylfolate, Vitamin B12, also called cobalamin, is vital for neurologic function, red blood cell production, and DNA synthesis. Vitamin B12 deficiency shows up as anemia and, in more severe cases, dementia, vision problems, and nerve problems, among other things. Fortunately, dementia is reversible if you catch it early enough by supplementing the vitamin B12. There are certain groups that are more prone to vitamin B12 deficiency. It's estimated that about 15% of people over the age of 60 have some degree of vitamin B12 deficiency because as we age, we absorb less vitamin B12. People with gastrointestinal disorders that cause poor absorption or block stomach acid can become deficient. Gastric bypass surgery results in less B12 absorption. And vegetarians can become B12 deficient because vitamin B12 is predominantly found in animal products like meat, poultry, fish, eggs, and dairy. While some plants absorb B12 from the soil and from symbiotic bacteria, these sources tend to be unreliable and usually don't provide enough vitamin B12. So here's the tie back to folate. Since folate is also involved in producing red blood cells, supplementing with folate may mask a vitamin B12 deficiency. As I mentioned, usually the early signs of B12 deficiency is anemia. Anemia can leave you feeling very tired all the time. If you take folate, you may feel better and have more energy, but if your anemia was from low levels of B12, the folate won't increase your B12 and you'll remain deficient and your symptoms can progress to affecting your memory and other things. So if you're going to start on L-methylfolate, it's a good idea just to be cautious to have your B12 level checked. There aren't a lot of downsides to adding folate unless it's expensive and not helping you. It's well tolerated with minimal side effects, so it may be worth a try if you're not responding well to your antidepressant. For other options for treatment-resistant depression, take a look at this video. Thanks for watching. See you next time.